discuss about the spear gap measurement. Okay, a uniform field spark gap will have a spark over voltage within a known tolerance under constant atmospheric conditions. We have already read about spear gap. Okay, in first experiment HV lab, we have learned breakdown strength, oil the breakdown strength to find out marbekada. Now spear gap ishte distance irbeku, ishte and then two spears madhya eshtu spacing irbeku adella now nodidive aita. First experimentally now tilkondidive adar bagge. A uniform field spark gap will have an always spark over voltage within a known tolerance under constant atmospheric conditions. Hence, a spark gap can be used for measurement of the peak value of voltage if the gap distance is known. We should know the distance between the gap, two spears, okay? Two spears will be there. A distance between the two spears, we should know, then only we can measure the peak value of the voltage. A spark over voltage of 30 kV peak at 1 centimeter spacing in air at 20 degrees Celsius and 760 ton pressure occurs for a spear gap measurement or any uniform field gap. But experience has shown that these measurements are reliable only for certain gap configuration. Okay, we can change the gap measurements. So in that experiment, we have taken 2.5 mm. Okay, normally only spear gap are used for voltage measurements. Only spear gaps are used for voltage measurement. In certain cases, uniform field gaps and rod gaps are also used, but their accuracy is less. In some cases, uniform field gaps and rod gaps are also used, but in that cases, accuracy is less. The spark gap breakdown, especially the spark gap breakdown, is independent of the voltage waveform and hence here highly suitable for all type of waveforms from DC to impulse voltage of short rise times. That is, rise time may be greater than or equal to 0.5 microseconds. As such, that spear gap measurement can be used for radio frequency AC voltage peak measurement. Spear gap measurement can be used for what? Radio frequency AC voltage peak measurements. This is the diagram. Up to what? Up to 1 megahertz. First is insulator, second is spear shank, okay, operating gear and motor for changing gap distance, that is the HV connection. Fourth is HV connection. P is a sparking point. This is a sparking point. And D is the diameter of the spear, okay, D is the diameter of the spear. S is the spacing, okay, distance, this is the S is the spacing. Height of the P above earth, A is the height of P above earth, A is the height of P above earth. B is the radius of the clearance from external structure. X is a high voltage lead should not pass through this plane within a distance B from P. This diagram is spear gap for voltage measurement. This is the vertical arrangement of spear gap. Spear gap measurement can be arranged either vertically with the lower spear grounded or horizontally with both spears connected to the source voltage or one spear grounded. In horizontal configuration, generally arrange it such that both spears are symmetrically at high voltage above the ground. In horizontal configuration, how it will be? Both spears will be symmetrical at high voltage above the ground. The two spears used are identical in size and also in shape. The schematic arrangement is shown in the figure, that is 17.7.98. This is the spherical arrangement for voltage measurement. And also 7.19b, this is the diagram for that. Okay, this is the horizontal arrangement of sphere gap. You can see this is a horizontal, okay, sphere gap is horizontal. It is generally arranged such that I have said that both symmetrically, spheres are symmetrically, and also high voltage above the ground. Two spheres we have used here, identical in size and also in shape. The voltage to be measured is applied between the two spheres. Okay, the voltage to be measured, which we need to measure, that voltage to be measured is applied between the two spheres, and the distance or spacing S between them gives a measure of the spark over voltage. A series resistance is usually connected between the source and the sphere gap. First is to limit the breakdown current, and to suppress the unwanted oscillation in the source voltage when breakdown occurs. Why we connect series resistance to between the source and the sphere gap? To limit the breakdown current and also to suppress the unwanted oscillations in the source voltage. When unwanted oscillations will occur? When the breakdown occurs. The value of the series resistance may vary from 100 to 1000 kilo ohms for AC and also for DC voltages, not more than 500 ohm in the case of impulse voltages. Okay, in the case of impulse voltages, resistance value should be 500. It should not more than 500. Okay, in the case of AC peak value and DC voltage measurements, the applied voltage is uniformly increased until spark over occurs in the gap. In the case of AC peak value and DC voltage measurements, the applied voltage gradually we will increase. Okay, applied voltage is uniformly increased. Gradually we will increase the until spark over occurs in the gap between the two spheres. Okay, generally a mean of about 5 breakdown values is taken when they agree to within ±3%, ±3%. Okay, usually we will take 5 breakdown values, and we will when they agree to within, we will get 5 readings. Okay, we will take 5 readings and we will do average for that. Okay, we have done first experiment. Okay, transformer oil, we have found out the transformer oil breakdown strength. In that case, we have found out the breakdown strength. We will apply voltage gradually, and when it spark over occurs, we will stop the dimmer start. Okay, we will stop rising the voltage, and we will note down the voltage, breakdown voltage. Like that, we need to take the 5 readings. In the case of impulse voltage, to obtain 50% flashover voltage, 2 voltage limits. Okay, in case of impulse voltage, to obtain 50% flashover voltage, 2 voltage limits. Okay, 2 voltage limits differing by not more than 2% or set such that application of lower limit value, either 2 or 4 flashover takes place, and on application of upper limit value, 8 or 6 flashover takes place. If the application not more than 2%, the application of lower limit value, either 2 or 4 flashover takes place. For another applications, for upper limit, it may occur 8 or 6 flashover takes place. The mean of these two limits is taken as 50% flashover voltage. In case any preliminary spark over voltage measurement is to be made before actually measurements are made. The flashover voltage for various gap distance and standard diameters of the spear gap measurement used are given this table 7.3 and 7.4 respectively. Okay. This is in the textbook, you can observe, okay. The standard, they have given standard diameter of the spear and standard diameter and also gap distance, okay. Gap distance, okay. They have given in this table 7.3 and 7.4. You can check in the textbook. The values of spark over voltages are specified in BS 358 IEC publication 52 of 1960 and also in IS 1876 of 1962. They have the values of spark over voltages are specified in these publications, and the clearance of necessary are shown in figure. Okay, clearance is plus or minus 3%. Okay, next, spear gap construction and assembly. Spear gaps are made with two metal spears of identical diameters D. They are made with two metal spears of identical diameter D with their shank operating gear and also insulator supports. You have seen in the diagram, right? First is the insulator support. Okay, this is the insulator support and spear shank. Okay. Spear gap measurements are generally made of what? It is made of copper, brass, or aluminium. The latter is used due to low cost. Okay. Latter also used because it is low cost. And the standard diameters for the spears are 2, 5, 6.25, 10, 12.5, 15, 25, 50, 75, 100, 150, and also 200 centimeter. These are the standard diameters for spear. The spacing is so designed, and chosen such that flashover occurs near the sparking point P. You can observe in the diagram, sparking point P is here. Okay. Spacing they will design depending upon the flash spear diameter, and also the spacing is designed and chosen such that flashover occurs. Flashover should occur near the sparking point P. The spears are carefully designed. And also fabricated so that the surface are smooth and the curvature is uniform. Okay, the spears will be carefully designed and also it is fabricated. That's why surface will be smooth and curvature is uniform. The radius of the curvature measured with the spearometer at various points over an area enclosed by a circle of 0.3 D around the sparking point should not differ by more than plus or minus 2%. They are saying that it is measured with the spear, the radius of curvature is measured with the spearometer, and the area enclosed by a circle of 0.3 into D. Okay, around the sparking point should not differ. Your sparking point should not differ by more than plus or minus 2% or the nominal value. Okay, the surface of the spear should be free from dust. That's why they have made with fabricated and surface is smooth, because the surface should be free from dust, grease or any other coating. Okay, the surface should be, you can observe, even insulators will be, the surface will be smooth because then dust should not fall on that, and it should not absorb the dust. Okay, that's why the surface will be, the surface of the insulator also, it will be smooth. Okay, the surface of the spear should be free from dust, grease or any other coating. The surface should maintain clean but need not to be polished. Okay, we should maintain clean, we no need to polish that one. Okay, we should maintain clean, that's it. If excessive pitting occurs due to repeated spark over, they should be smooth end. If any repeated spark over occurs, then we need to smooth. There should be smooth end. Okay. The dimension of the shank used, the grading ring used with the spear, the ground clearance, etc., should follow the values indicated in the figure. Okay. And table 7.5 you need to check in the textbook. The high voltage conductor should be arranged such that it does not affect the field configuration. High voltage conductor should be arranged such that it should not affect the field configuration. Okay. Series resistance connected should be outside the shank at distance 2D. The series resistance connected should be outside the shank at a distance of 2D away from the high voltage spear or the sparking point P. Series resistance, where it should be connected? It should be connected outside the shank and at a distance of 2D. Okay, 2D away from the voltage spear or the sparking point P. Irradiation of spear gap. Irradiation of spear gap measurement is needed when measurement of voltage less than 50 kV. They are saying that irradiation of spear gap measurement when voltage is less than 50 kV are made with spear gap measurement of 10 centimeter diameter or less. The irradiation may be obtained from a quartz tube mercury vapor lamp. It is irradiation may be obtained from a quartz tube mercury vapor lamp of 40 watt rating. Okay. Next, influencing the spark over voltage of spear gaps. Okay. First is, or we can say factors that affect the spark over voltage of a spear gap. Nearby active objects, atmospheric conditions and the humidity, irradiation and polarity and rise time of voltage waveforms. First, we shall read about the effect of nearby active objects. The effect of nearby active objects was investigated by Kufel. Okay. This was investigated by Kufel by enclosing the arced sphere inside an arced cylinder. It was observed that spark over voltage is reduced. The reduction was observed to be delta V is equal to M log open bracket B divided by D plus C. Okay, delta V is a percentage reduction, B is a diameter of arced enclosing cylinder, D is a diameter of the sphere, S is a spacing, and M and C are constants. The reduction was less than 2% for S/D less than 0.5 and B/D greater than 0.8. Even for S/D equals to 1 and B/D greater than 1. The reduction was only 3%. Hence, if the specifications regarding the clearance are closely observed, the error is within the tolerance and accuracy specified. The variation of breakdown voltage with A or A/D, that is A/D ratio, is given in figure. That this is the figure. Okay, influence of ground planes on spark over voltage. A/D ratio is 4.2, and here in this case same. Okay, 4.2 it is. The reduction in voltage is within the accuracy limits if S/D is kept less than 0.6 in the above ratio. A is the distance and from sparking point to horizontal ground plane. Okay. You know about what is A and SD. Okay, I have explained in figure. Okay, spark gap measurement. Effect of atmospheric conditions. The spark over voltage of a spear gap depends on the air density. It depends on the air density, which varies with the changes in both temperature and pressure. If the spark over voltage is V under test conditions, temperature T and pressure P, if the spark over voltage is V naught under standard conditions of temperature T, then 20 degrees Celsius and pressure P is equal to 760 tau, then V is equal to K into V naught, where K is a function of the air density factor. This is given by D is given by D is equal to P divided by 760 open bracket 293 divided by 273 plus T close bracket. This is the relationship between the D and K is given in the table. Okay. Relation between correction factor K and air density factor D. Okay. The spark over voltage increases with humidity. Spark over voltage will increases with humidity. The increase is about 2 to 3% overall normal humidity range. Okay. The influence of humidity on spark over voltage of a 25 centimeter spear gap for 1 centimeter spacing is presented. The influence of humidity on spark over voltage 25 centimeter spear gap for 1 centimeter spacing is presented. This is the graph for that influence of humidity on DC and AC breakdown voltages, that is 25 centimeter dia spear gap and 1 centimeter spacing. Dotted lines are DC voltages, X is AC voltages. Hence, it may be conducted that humidity effect increases with the size of sphere and is maximum for uniform field gap. Humidity effect will increase with the size of sphere, or that is it will increase with the size of sphere and it is a maximum for uniform field gaps. The spark over voltage increases with the partial pressure P also. It will increase with the partial pressure P of water vapor in air for a given humidity condition. The change in spark over voltage increases with the gap length also. Okay, the change in spark over voltage with humidity is within 3%. No correction is normally given for humidity. Effect of irradiation. Illumination of spear gap with the ultraviolet or X-ray aids easy ionization in gaps. The effect of irradiation is pronounced for small gap spacing. A reduction of about 20% in spark over voltage was observed for spacing 0.1D and to 0.3D for 1.3 centimeter spear gap with DC voltages. The reduction in spark over voltage is less than 5% for gap spacing more than 1 centimeter. They are saying that reduction in spark over voltage is less than 5% for what? For gap spacing more than 1 centimeter. And for gap spacing of 2 centimeter, it is more about 1.5%. Okay. Spark over voltage is more 1.5%. Hence, irradiation is necessary for smaller spear gaps of gap spacing less than 1 centimeter for obtaining consistent values. Okay, for small spear gaps, we need the irradiation is necessary for small spear gaps of gap spacing is less than 1 centimeter. Okay, for what? For obtaining consistent values. Effect of polarity and waveform. It has been observed that spark over voltages for positive and also for negative polarity impulses and are different. Okay, spark over voltages for positive and negative polarity impulses, it is different. Experimental investigation showed that for spear gaps of 6.25 to 25 centimeter diameter, the difference between positive and negative DC voltages is not more than 1%. Okay, the difference is not more than 1%, but when you investigate the spear gap 6.25 to 25 centimeter, the difference somewhat difference, that is 1%. For small spear gap 2 centimeter diameter and less than, the difference was about 8% between negative and positive impulses of 1/50 microseconds waveform. Similarly, the wavefront and wave tail duration also influences the breakdown voltage here. Here, wavefront and wave tail also influence the breakdown voltage. Wavefront of less than 0.5 microseconds and wave tail less than 5 microseconds, breakdown voltages are not consistent, and hence the use of spear gap is not recommended for voltage measurement in such cases. Okay, effect of polarity. So they have not prefer or recommend for use of spear gap in such cases. Okay. Next is potential dividers for impulse voltage measurement. Okay, this I will explain in the next class. Thank you.